The moment a lot of people have been waiting for is finally here. We have ported the Media Element to .NET MAUI. With this, we get a control that allows you to play audio and video inside of your .NET MAUI app. Let's go check it out. You might already know about the Media Element from the Xamarin Community Toolkit, where it's still available for your Xamarin Forms applications, and it allows you to play audio and video from within your own app. Now we've rebuilt it from the ground up. It's still called Media Element, but now we've re-implemented it for .NET MAUI. So now you can play audio and video files, even live streams, HLS, some amazing cool things from your .NET MAUI application. In this video, we're going to see how to get started with the Media Element. And at the end of the video, I'm going to talk a little bit about what it can and can't do and where the future is going for these marvelous controls. Let's switch over to my computer and see how to get started yourself. Can everyone see my screen? Oh wait, this is not an online meeting. This is my YouTube video. Of course you can see my screen. All right, here we are in Visual Studio 2022. I just created a file new .NET MAUI application. And to get started with the Media Element, we need to install the library for that. Now, while it lives with the Community Toolkit, it doesn't really have a dependency on a Community Toolkit, and it lives in a separate package even. So let's just right-click on our project in Solution Explorer, manage NuGet packages, and we're going to search for Community Toolkit MAUI.MediaElement, and it should pop up. At the time of recording, it should have version 1.0.1. We already had a minor update so that we could get rid of a crazy little bug that was preventing you from having a nice first time experience. So we have this, and we have a couple of dependencies here. Actually, for Android, we're using the Exo Player now, which gives us a lot of opportunity out of the box for some nice stuff. And the thing that you can take from here is that it supports .NET 7. So from .NET 7 and up is the support, which a couple of people already asked, like, hey, but .NET 6 is the long-term support version. Yes, for the bigger .NET, that is definitely the case. For .NET MAUI, the support policy is a little bit different. So for .NET MAUI apps, you probably want to be on the latest .NET version anyway. If that confuses you, I can totally understand. Let me know down in the comments and I'll maybe make a video explaining how that all works. So .NET 7 and up, just install this on your project. Don't need anything else. You can see all the dependencies that are coming in here, and we click OK. Make sure that you read all the license agreements. I already did, so I can accept them. And whenever you do, we're going to be presented with that README. Now, I'm going to explain all of this to you, and we're developers, so we're not going to read documentation anyway. But the thing that's really neat about this README is that we can copy and paste this little line right here. So let's just close this one and go over to our MauiProgram.cs. So go to your Solution Explorer, MauiProgram.cs, and here we have our app builder, right? And you can see it already starts giving us red squigglies saying that we need to use MAUI Community Toolkit Media Element, that call in our app builder, because it sees that we have included our Media Element package, but we didn't do the initialization line yet. Smart, right? Because we know you don't read documentation, so we included something so that you cannot build your app without doing the proper thing here. So let's just paste that in here. You can also type it yourself, of course. Use MAUI Community Toolkit Media Element, and make sure that that imports this using community-toolkit.maui, and now you're all good to go. You don't need any extra permissions. Of course, if you're going to do things from the file system, then you might need extra permissions. But just for playing videos from remote URLs, you're not going to need any extra permissions or other stuff. So we're done with this MAUI program. Let's close that. And we're going to go to our mainpage.xaml. Now, one other thing that we want to do before we get started here is add that XML namespace so that we can actually, you know, grab the toolkit without doing all kinds of crazy stuff. So we're going to say XML NS. I'm going to name this toolkit. You can name the toolkit part whatever you want to make it more recognizable or shorter or whatnot, and here just search for toolkit and you will get this URL kind of thing, which the only thing this does is bundle all the namespaces that are inside of this toolkit package under one identifier here, which is the toolkit, so that you don't have to specify a number of separate XML namespaces here. I'm going to leave this scroll view, vertical stack layout, and I'm going to remove all of this, maybe keep the button so I can trigger some functionality there. But now what I can do is add this toolkit media element, and boom, we've implemented the media element. There we are. There is a couple of other things that you might want to do. So you might want to set a width request. Let's set that to 400, a height request of 300, something like that. And of course, you want to set a source, right? Now, I don't know where this came from. If you do know, please let me know down in the comments. For all media players, it seems like everyone is doing something with Big Bug Bunny, which is an animated little movie, and every media player that's being demoed basically shows that movie. So I have this link right here that will actually show us that as well. And let's just deploy this to Android, and you can see the media element showing up on Android with just, you know, two lines of code, a little bit of initialization, and a little bit of XAML. Of course, you can also do this in C# code if that's what you want. And it will start playing this video inside of your dotnet MAUI app. So that is how easy it is. Now, while this is deploying, let's see some other APIs here. So we have a bunch of other properties, of course. So we have, we can set the volume, we can set the speed. We also have a couple of should. So should autoplay, whenever the media is loaded successfully, should it automatically start playing, yes or no? The default is false. So we should see the media element, but it's not going to play automatically whenever it pops up. Here we are. We do have some other things. What do we have? Should keep screen on. So whenever the media is actually playing, should it keep the screen on and not go to sleep, which is more relevant, I guess it is. Definitely implemented for the desktops as well, but it's more relevant on the mobile devices, where your device will not go to sleep whenever a video is playing. Should loop playback. So whenever it reaches the end of the video, is it going to go back to the beginning and play the full video again? So you can loop your media like that as well. Or should show playback controls. So if we go to the actual Android emulator now, we can see the playback controls right here from the platform. And should show playback controls, true or false. Whenever we set it to false, it's not going to show those controls. And you have to do stop and play and pause, which are methods on the media element. You should do that yourself. Or you cannot do that, and the user just cannot interact with the video, right? You're just gonna play it in their face. So if whenever I start play here, you can see this Big Bug Bunny video is going to start to play. Of course, there's audio, it's not gonna be in the video, but this is just going here, and you can scrub through it, you can go to other places in the video, you can, I don't know, select the speed here, you can do all kinds of things. So this is how easy it is to just get started with playing a video. Now, if we stop this and explore a little bit more, so maybe let's give this a little reference here. So X name is media element, so I can reference it from code. And let's go to this little button, click me here, so that we actually can show the things here as well. So maybe I can do something from code here as well and explore some APIs here. So like I said, we have play, we have stop, we have pause, so we can all do all these things, right? So, and I also have a current state, right? So what I can say here is if media player, media element dot current state is whatever the state is going to be. So is it playing? Then it's going to, I don't know what it's going to do. Then it's probably going to stop or pause, right? So media element dot pause. And whenever it's actually else, if media element dot current state is, and then we say stopped or paused, and maybe I said paused, right? We're going to actually, well, we're not going to pause, we're going to play. There we are. So we have that. And what else do we have? So we also have like the position, right? So you can implement a little slider or some other progress bar that shows the position. We also have an event position change. So whenever the position changes, you can do things with that. I think I already handled the volume. We have some other events as well. So on, no, we have media. There we go. Media ended. So whenever the end of the media has been reached, media failed whenever something happens. The width and the height of the media, of course, that's only applicable whenever it's a video, and the media open, so whenever the media has successfully been opened, all kinds of events that you can work with. So there's already a lot of power incorporated in this media element right here, which is pretty cool. Now all these properties that you're seeing here, let's run it for Windows just for fun so that you can see it runs on Windows as well. All these properties that you've just seen are also bindable properties. So you can also just bind to it from XAML and not even use code at all. Which makes it really powerful. Now, this sample is going to be available on GitHub. Find the link down below. But there's also a sample incorporated in the community toolkit sample in the repository, which is, I think it covers all the functionality that's in a media element right now. So if you're not sure how to do something, definitely go check that out. Here you can see how it shows on Windows. And I can use this play button, but I should be able to use this button as well. And you can see that it starts playing. And whenever I click it again, it's going to pause, right? So you can also use that state and implement your own controls if that's what you want, and use it with this button. Now, this is using it with a URL. What I also did, a short thing that I just want to show you, is in the Solution Explorer, I already added a resource to my .NET MAUI app here in the Resources and Raw folder. I have this, it's called Android Video, because it came from a demo where I wanted to show setting a different video for each platform. So I'm using the Android Video right here. But you can use that inside of your resources, just stick it in there, don't do anything else. And then here, in your XAML, to make sure that it gets it from the embedded resources, we came up with a little bit of, I don't know, syntax, if you will. So instead of doing this source, I'll put this in a comment down here so you can see it for the sample code whenever you get to that. But what you can then also do is just say embed, and you can say Android video.mp4. It can be in a folder, so if it would be in a folder called videos, you could go to videos/android videos, you can do all of that. And whenever it's in the local file system, so the difference is embedded is delivered with your application. Whenever it's on the local file system, so on your C drive on Windows, for example, then you can say file system, and then that thing, right? That makes it a little bit easier to discover these things and work with them. So let's just do this. You can also set it from code, right? Where we have like media source, and that makes it a little bit different. But from XAML, you can do these kinds of stuff, right? So you can say media source. I need to add the right using here. And whoops, don't need to do that. And then I can say from URI or from file or from resource, right? So then it's kind of like clear from the context what you're actually doing. So there we have that. But if we want to do the embed one and I run it on Windows again, then it's now going to get that Android video and you're going to see me. So I'm going to be down here, but I'm also going to be on the screen. So let's just play this. And you can see here, it loads it from that embedded things and it's going to show it here as well. So that's a little syntactic thing that you can use to make it easier to play videos from your embedded resources. And that is how easy it is to get started with the MediaElement for .NET MAUI. This is already pretty powerful stuff, but there is much more that you can think of whenever you think of a MediaElement, right? Like playing playlists, using videos with DRM, digital rights management, something like that. Live streaming, there is live streaming support already in there. HLS should work, HTTP live streaming, some other things. There is a little bit of difference between platforms, what is supported and what is not. We have the documentation already in place that links to like the platform counterparts that tell more about what formats are supported, yes or no. So definitely go check that out. The link is down below. And sending different like custom headers for accessing maybe protected resources that you want to load. There is a lot of stuff to think of whenever you think of a media player. And please let us know in the repository or down below in the comments, at least, so I can point you to the right direction. What is the stuff that is important to you? What do you want to see in the media element? And of course, if you're going to use it yourself, and what did you think? What did you run into? I basically want to know everything. And most of all, I want to see amazing projects that you are building with this. Thank you so much for watching again one of my videos. Please don't forget to click the like button so even more people get to know about the media element that has now been implemented for .NET MAUI, and check out this video, this playlist with .NET MAUI videos, this playlist with more .NET MAUI Community Toolkit videos, and click this button to actually subscribe to my channel, because you did that already, right? See you for the next one.